Today we are going to study the paper 5, that is the semester 3rd. The topic name is Animal Diversity 2nd. The animal diversity 1st can be studied in the BSc part 1st. In this unit 1st, one is the protocordates. In this protocordates, we are going to study about the general characters and classification of the protocordates. So before going to study the general characters and classification of protocordates, we must know about the main characters of the phylum Chordata. So the first one is the presence of dorsal tubular nervous system. Second one is the presence of notochord. And third one is the presence of the pharyngeal gill slits. We see the main three characters of the phylum Chordata, that is in a typical chordate. You see here the presence of dorsal tubular nerve cord, that is the in the form of neural tube, which is located at the dorsal side of the body. And second character, that is the presence of notochord. This notochord is located on the dorsal side of the body, but it is ventral to the neural tube. And third one is the presence of gill slits on the digestive system. Then we see the classification of phylum Chordata. This Chordata can be divided into three subphylum. First one is the Urochordata, or it is also called as Tunicata. Second one is the Cephalochordata, and third one is the Vertebrata, or it is also called as the Craniata. The subphylums, that is Urochordata and Cephalochordata, are collectively called as the protocordates. Then we see the general characters and classification of the subphylum, that is Urochordata. First character, that is the animals which are included in the subphylum Urochordata, all are marine, and commonly they are called as the sea scourges or the tunicates. Second, the adults are mostly fixed, that is, they are fixed to the substratum. They are solitary, that means they live singly, or they also live in colonies, that is colonial, or sometimes they are the aggregated forms, that is a number of individuals come together to aggregate. Then fourth character, body is enclosed in a bag, that is called as the test, or it is also called as the tunic. So these animals are commonly called as the tunicates. Fifth, the pharynx is large, sac-like, and it is perforated by gill slits. The notochord is confined or restricted to tail region of the larva. Hence, these are called as the urochordates. Larva shows retrogressive metamorphosis, that is the change in forms. Then coelom is not recognizable. That means we will not identify the cavity in the body. Endostyle is present. Then animals show ciliary mode of the feeding. That is, at the time of feeding, the beating of the cilia takes place. That is, to catch the prey. The alimentary canal is U-shaped. That is, it looks like the U. The nervous system is better developed in larva, but reduced in adults. Sexes are united, that is called as the bisexual, and reproduction takes place sexual as well as the asexual type of the methods. Then we study about the classification of subphylum Urochordata. This subphylum Urochordata can be classified into three classes. First one is the Acidiaceae, second Thaliaceae, third Larvaceae. Further, this class Acidiaceae can be divided into two orders. First one is the Enterogona, second Pleurogona. Example of the Enterogona are Ciona, Acidia and Clavellina. Then the examples of the Pleurogona are Botrylus, then Molgula and the Herdmania. Then the Thalassia class can be further divided into three orders. First one is Dulioida, second Pyrosomida, third one is the Salpida. The example of the order Dolioida is the Doliolum. Then order Pyrosomida is the Pyrosoma, and the Salpa is the example of order Salpidia. Then we will see about the class 3, that is the Larvacea. This class Larvacea also further divided into two orders. First one is the Endostylophora, example Oikopleura, and second one is the Polystylophora. The example is Kowalewski. Now first we see about the class Acidiaceae. In Greek, the Acidion means a bag. The animals which present in a bag or test. The silent features, that is the fixed or free swimming. The animals which are included in the class Acidiaceae all are fixed to the substratum, or some animals are also free swimming. They are solitary or colonial. That means the animals live singly, or they may found in colonies. Larvae are more developed than the adults. Then presence of many gill slits. Then the development is indirect. The class Acidiaceae can be divided into two orders. That is, order first one is the Enterogona. The silent features of the order Enterogona are, first one is the neural glands in ventral to ganglion. That is, This gland is present to the ventral ganglion. Second one is the single gonad behind the intestinal lobe. It consists two types of sense organs. First one is the photoreceptor, that means these are sensitive to the light. And second one is the presence of the otocyst. It helps in the balancing of the animal. The examples of the order Enterogona are Acidia, then Ciona and Clavellina, etc. We look at the example of the Acidia. So this animal Acidia is attached to the substratum with the help of the foot. Then it bears two siphons, that is the atrial siphon and second one is the oral or branchial siphons. So these two siphons have the apertures or holes, which is called as the oral or branchial aperture and the atrial aperture. Then second one is the order Pleurogona. The general characters, that is neural glands, are present dorsal or lateral to the ganglion. Gonads, two or more in mantle wall. Then third one is the larva has no photoreceptors, that is the ocellus. Then presence of the otocyst, that is the balancing sense organ. Examples of the order Pleurogona are the Hardmania, then Botrylus and the Morgula. You see the example of the Hardmania, that the animal looks like a bag. So this body is perforated by two apertures. One is called as the oral aperture and second one is the atrial aperture.